Hey guys, Jcers here. When talking about parkour in Assassin's Creed, the system present in the Kenway games often tends to go overlooked and is seen as very middle of the road when looking at people's ranking lists. However, after spending a large amount of time playing AC3 over the past while, I've gained a better understanding of the movement system and I feel like a lot of people are missing out on a good portion of its depth, especially in AC3. AC3 is often resented for having cities that people consider to be bad for parkour, but after delving deep into the different ways to use all of the mechanics, I've come to realize that AC3 was actually the first AC game to truly support controlled descents, you know, barring vaulting in AC1. I figured I would make a tutorial to show people some of my findings so that they could enjoy moving around in Boston and New York more than they originally had. Without any further ado, let's get right into it. In AC Wonder Revelations, the player could descend short drops by running off of them in high profile. AC3 changed the way movement works so that sprinting was now accomplished by holding only the high profile button, meaning that descents would have to be accomplished another way. The way the devs went about this was by adding an additional button input used to drop straight down, which is Anvil Next's version of Parkour Down. The controls for this are identical to AC Unity's implementation of the mechanic. Just hold high profile on the loot button when running towards a ledge and Connor will drop straight down. This can be done from heights of about 2 stories before Connor sustains fall damage. This mechanic is great because it's actually possible to kill yourself by using it recklessly due to the fact that it can be performed regardless of Connor's distance to the ground. However, there is a major control conflict here which ends up causing major problems for the use of this mechanic. A big problem with this mechanic is that it shares a control input with tackling, and the Kenway games still allow you to tackle targets from above, like in the Ezio games. This often has the unfortunate side effect of causing you to jump tackle a random guard in the street from the rooftops, thus bringing the entire military population of the American colonies down on your head. Because of this, using Parkour Down in the Kenway games can often be frustrating, but the fortunate thing is that there are still many different ways to get down from rooftops in cities without accidentally instigating a massive conflict. The first and most obvious solution for descending from rooftops is the classic leap of faith. Keep an eye out for birds or white marks on the edges of roofs or on beams near areas where you're looking to descend. AC3 also has moving carts that can appear opportunistically, so make sure to use them when they're helpful to you. One more thing that isn't really related to movement, but I figure is worth mentioning anyway, is that performing a leap of faith from a high rooftop will always cause your detection state to instantly return to anonymous. This is essentially your get-out-of-jail-free card if you don't feel like fighting 37 people at once, should you get detected in the streets. V-shaped trees are the second easiest solution for descending gracefully. To parkour down using a tree, simply enter the V-shaped area at the top, face towards the inside of the tree, then hold parkour down without using your movement inputs until Connor drops to the ground. If you're looking for style points, make sure to hold forward on your movement inputs so that Connor rolls when he hits the ground from out of the tree. There are other ways to use trees to parkour down, but we'll touch on that later. A third method of descending to street level consists of using the metallic poles that can be found near rooftops. Running towards the edge of a roof where one of these is near enough to the ledge will have Connor jump down to it and begin swinging off of it. There are several different places you can go from here. The first is to continue down the parkour starter that the pole exists in and drop downwards at some point later on in the chain. The second actually doesn't usually involve the use of parkour down, but rather the jump button. When Connor is jumping down to swing off of the pole, aim outwards toward the street with your movement inputs and hold the jump button. Holding this button will have him swing off of the pole regardless of the distance between him and the ground, which allows you to swing straight down to street level in one motion. In the event where the pole is closer to the ground though, it's better to hold parkour down so that Connor doesn't path up onto the parkour starter that follows. In general, dropping straight down off of rooftops can be somewhat precarious as if the game decides to lock you onto a guard below you, you will almost certainly end up tackling them, resulting in a long fight or a chase sequence. However, there exists a way to prevent the game from allowing Connor to tackle targets from above, namely by having momentum that is perpendicular to the direction of a non-standing surface. To put it in simpler terms, being on a surface that Connor cannot stand upright on, such as beams, tree branches, small platforms on the sides of buildings, or fences on rooftops, and moving perpendicularly to them prevents Connor from tackling targets from above, even if they are directly below him. One of the best places to use this technique is on fences on the edges of roofs, as this allows you to drop straight down the wall and catch ledge near the bottom by pointing your movement inputs towards the building before softly dropping the remainder of the short distance to the ground. In the event that there are beams or street signs on the side of the building, you can use these to perform controlled descents a la AC Unity and gracefully descend to street level. One thing worth noting is that it's usually better to just tap Parkour down than to hold it when performing these types of actions, as Connor can tend to decide to play a short game of hopscotch at times when Parkour down is held, and also because Connor doesn't automatically gravitate towards objects that are some ways below him like Arno does. So holding it can often cause him to just drop straight down earlier than you might like, or worse, before you have time to turn him perpendicular to the beam that you're dropping off of, and he locks onto an enemy to tackle from above. Sometimes, you may need to descend in a spot where there are no nearby rooftop fences, poles, trees, or haystacks. Fortunately, if there are street signs or beams on a building's side below a flat ledge, running off of said ledge holding only high profile will have Connor automatically drop down to the beams below it, provided they are within height range, and that there are no other objects at a height level similar to Connor's that he could reach. This comes in handy when you need to descend from flat ledges and there are guards nearby that prevent you from being able to just drop straight down off the ledge without any worry. The last method for descending from roofs is one that you'll be familiar with if you've played AC1 to Revelations. Parkour starters in those games often tended to be ways to get down from roofs as well as ways to get up onto them, and AC3 is no different. Just find a spot that gives easy jumping access to a pole, beam, street sign, or platform and follow the path downwards. This is especially useful in areas with narrow streets, as Connor can easily drop down onto parkour starters across from him, and even jump between the parkour sequences of the two buildings for style points. One other thing that combines well with this method is a property of movement that was brought to my attention by Takirius. Namely, AC3 has a form of inertia applied to his jumps. If you jump towards a beam and let go of high profile before you land, but continue holding your movement inputs forward, Connor will drop down to any surface below him that's within range. You can use this to proc parkour down animations when there are world objects on the ground under the beams in the starters. Those are the main methods I've determined to be useful for descending from rooftops and cities in AC3. If you have any others that I haven't mentioned here, be sure to leave them down in the comment section below. Overall, I feel like AC3 is a game that went largely underappreciated in terms of mechanics, and I've been doing my best to gain mastery of everything in the game to eventually be able to make videos like this one that might help people enjoy the game a little bit more. I'll be making some form of an AC3 stealth guide video at some point, so be on the lookout for that. Other than that, I hope that this video was helpful to you, and as always, I will see you next time.